The Klingons are willing to use any weapon available to destroy the Federation, even time itself. It falls to a small group of brave Starfleet officers to restore the timeline and rescue one of their own. Who controls this sector may determine who controls the war.
All Federation ships in range. This is the USS Boyce. We are taking fire from Gorn fighters and need aid from any ships in range. Repeat, we are being attacked by Gorn and need help. steady. We can handle it from here. Thanks for the helping hand. Hopefully, we'll be able to finish our medical deliveries without too much of a delay.
I am Salar, captain of the Vulcan medical ship, T'Pau. There is an outbreak of Tachanian syndrome on the planet's surface. It is of utmost importance that the medical supplies we carry be delivered immediately. Please, accompany us to the planet and defend us from enemy ships. Detecting weapons fire on the planet's surface. My ship is on a mission of peace. We are unequipped to deal with armed resistance. Will you secure the area so our healers can transport to the planet's surface safely?
Thank goodness you've arrived. We've been overwhelmed. Klingons and Gorn, ransacking the whole place. Good to see you here. Those Klingons and Gorn have been wiping us out. As far as I can tell, they're ransacking this place for medical supplies. This is a research hospital, with the best technology Zarantine has to offer. I don't know. The Gorn have been going through all the computers and medical kits. They're definitely looking for something specific. Good to see you here. Look, yes, this is definitely some kind of shared operation between them. The Klingons are doing the fighting, but the Gorn have been taking care of the science. They're the ones looking through the files and taking gear and sample containers. Good to see you here. Those Klingons and... You don't have to tell me twice.
I don't know.
Ah, you're early.
This facility has sustained some damage. I expect that my crew will be able to restore this wing to functionality in 52.3 minutes. Your decisive action has potentially saved the lives of many patients today. I cannot speak to the larger issues of the Gorn and Klingon attacks. Logic suggests that if the Gorn left any clues behind, my crew will find them while they are making repairs. Do not hesitate to speak with them for further information. Your assistance has been appreciated, but the situation is now stable. You may depart at your leisure.
Peace and long life to you. A rare virus that attacks the blood cells of some humanoids. The disease was first diagnosed 47.6 years ago on Tokken 3. Victims of Tokenian syndrome slowly stop producing red blood cells. If left untreated, the disease is always fatal. We will administer a series of injections to the patients over the course of the next 3 weeks. The treatment can be uncomfortable, but if given in time, the recovery rate is 100%. A team at Starfleet Medical used the Fabrini cure for xenopolycythemia discovered by Ambassador Spock and Admiral Leonard McCoy in 2268 as the basis for a treatment. Xenopolycythemia and Tokenian syndrome are similar in nature. The Vulcan Science Academy is attempting to determine if the two diseases are linked in some way.
Treated for Tokenian syndrome. There's been some kind of outbreak lately. I don't know much about it, other than that the doctors say I need a transplant of my own bone marrow, resequenced and cloned. Please, you have to help us. Now, the Gorn and the Klingons put those force fields up when they arrived. They didn't want any of us to escape. Most of us patients here can barely stand. We're not going anywhere. Please, you have to help us. He was asking about all the medical supplies, tests, the resequencing virus, the cell growth chambers, everything. I don't know about these things. I'm just a patient here.
Good work. I'm looking forward to reviewing your report. On first glance, it's clear that the Klingons are doing something with genetic modification. Since they don't have their own equipment, they're stealing ours. This is a bad road, and I suspect there's worse news to come.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
We have reports of a True Way fleet entering the neutral zone and picking a fight with the Klingons near the Donatu system. Having two of our enemies fight is good for the Federation, but I want to know why the True Way is so far out of their territory. Intercept them and deal with them. If you need to engage the Klingons as well, do so. A Starfleet task force has already been sent to the area. You'll need to join them in the Donatu system as soon as possible. Until next time.
Thank you.
On the front lines of the Klingon Federation War, brave captains from both sides battle to defend their homes and gain advantages for their faction. Each death has meaning, every victory can turn the tide. These are the conflicts that will determine the fate of the Quadrant.
Thank you. Well, the Axon has disabled or destroyed 7 enemy ships. I look forward to reporting our successes. The chief medical officer is concerned about casualties. It is his job to be concerned. Mine is to operate this ship at peak efficiency. I have read his report about unexplained deaths and dismissed it. There is always an explanation. He simply hasn't looked hard enough for it. I cannot let his failings disrupt our mission. Goma Dread is looking for men of purpose to assist him. He wants leaders with the will to use whatever means are necessary to free our people from Federation tyranny. If all goes well, after this campaign, I will be seen as one of those leaders.
Repairs to the Axon go as expected. Running low on deuterium and warp coils. Wish there was more time between battles to do more than patch critical systems. The time is the most precious commodity there. 4 crewmen down. 1 died in battle with Klingon forces, but 3 others died in accidents. I have spoken to the captain about launching an investigation, but he sees nothing but his dreams of glory and a return to conquest. Unusual spike in Dryalic wave energy may be affecting warp core efficiency. Must speak to Dryalic and see if his sensor readings have turned up anything unusual. Letter from Maja arrived today. She and the children are well. But she worries about me. She wants me to leave the True Way and return to Cardassia Prime. 6 months ago, I would have ignored her pleas. Now, I miss her. I see no end to this fighting. Perhaps she is right.
Science officer's log, stardate 86790.8. My duties on a combat mission are limited, but I was pleased today to have a chance to scan the approaching Griffin's Comet. The comet itself has not been a focus of much scientific inquiry, and it last passed through this sector in the late 23rd century. My scans, however, reveal surprising amounts of Dryalic wave energy emitting from the comet, as well as detectable amounts of chronoton particles. The Dryalic waves will unfortunately prevent a closer study of the comet. They are quite harmful to humanoid life forms, and the captain is loath to jeopardize our mission for my curiosity. I have requested the launch of a Class 1 probe. The chronotons are of even greater interest. They appear in instances of temporal disturbances, which could mean that this comet has been, or will be, in the presence of a temporal event. Time mechanics are so cumbersome. I must have more data. But the captain has never had much interest in science. Perhaps I will remind him that chronoton particles are harmful against the aliens who live in the Bajoran wormhole. A potential weapon to use against the Bajoran's gods may be of enough interest to him to divert our course.
Are you sure you found no sign of the Cardassians attempting to open a portal or otherwise bring the Davidians into our phase variants? This is troublesome. There are pieces to the puzzle I don't have yet. Let me do some digging and I will be in touch. Until next time.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
These are your active traits. You can activate available traits from the list on the left.
Until next time. Until next time.